It's crazy. 360 hertz is like something else. I love it when manufacturers listen to me, and I've been saying for years that 4K panels make absolutely no sense in 15-inch laptops because the pixel density is so high that all you're doing is pushing more pixels, which is harder on your GPU and potentially harder on your battery, without the actual benefit of a sharper image, because 1440p at that screen size is plenty. And check this out. In front of me, I have an assortment of engineering sample laptops from ASUS that incorporate a bunch of really good display ideas. Which one do you want to see first? Should we see the follow-up to the G14? Well, that's only sort of the follow-up to the G14, because this one actually contains old G14 hardware, except for the panel. You guys might remember this one. It's got a Ryzen 4800H processor, RTX, I believe it's 2060? This is it, right here, ladies and gentlemen. 1440p, 144 hertz. 1440p is such a freaking sweet spot. Like, if you've got eagle eyes, you can absolutely read the text because it's sharp enough that it's not like pixelated and aliased, but not wasteful. Sharpness compared to a 1080p panel, fantastic. And yeah, 4K would be sharper. I mean, it's 8 million plus pixels instead of just about 3.5. But it's so much more demanding to run. And from my point of view, because remember guys, there's resolution in terms of pixel count, but there's also resolution in terms of motion clarity. Like, resolution just means how your eyes can, how clearly your eyes can resolve an image. So would I rather have a sharper image with a ton of judder because I'm running at low frame rates? Or would I rather have a slightly less sharp image, although it still looks really good at this screen size, but have much better motion clarity? Well, for me, the answer is obvious. Let's go ahead and fire up a game though. I'm actually very excited about this development. This video is brought to you by Wondershare. PDF Element is their all-in-one smart PDF editor that offers the easiest way to create, edit, convert, annotate, and sign PDF documents on Windows and on Mac. You can transform any PDF to and from Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint without losing the formatting, and easily collect analysis-ready data from your clients with fillable PDF forms from paper or existing electronic files. You can add certified digital signatures to help your recipients validate document authenticity and integrity, and you can click the link in the video description to save 50% on PDF Element. All right, now we're at 150 FPS. Oh, that's feeling fine. And I don't even have to try to feel like, oh yeah, you know, maybe this is noticeable. Even with anti-aliasing off, I might get a little bit of kind of shimmering or stair-stepping in very distant objects with diagonal lines, like these stairs right here. I can see a little bit of aliasing nonsense, but at 1440p, like, this has similar pixel density to something like, so a 27-inch 5K display. Like, it's really dense, so it's really fine. So even when you're sitting really close like this, it just looks great. And being able to have the best of both worlds, where you've got high refresh rate and this pixel density, is, it's freaking awesome. A gaming laptop from 6 years ago just looks like garbage by today's standards. This is what we're gonna have. IPS. If this is the exact panel that's gonna be on the production model, I'd be thrilled with it. I mean, I'm not looking at a UFO test or like doing a proper pursuit camera setup or anything like that, but in terms of pixel response times, it looks really good. And this isn't even the best one that I've got here today. I have a 360 hertz display that we're gonna be checking out on a laptop. Oh, hold on a second. No, we're not gonna go straight to the 360 hertz. We've got a WQHD, so that's a 1440p model that is 165. Again, this is running older hardware on the inside, so we're gonna, this is not it. Wait a second. They're doing an ROG Zephyrus that's 4K 120? Now that's interesting. Okay, let's have a look at this panel. This thing is so freaking insane. Got your secondary display that lifts up, got your Twitch chat, touchscreen. It's kind of creepy because you don't see this very often. It almost feels like ASUS is listening to customers. So Brandon, you want to know something? Not only did we just get a 1440p 165 hertz display in a gaming laptop, both of these displays and that one are matte. Matte displays are back, Brandon. Consumers for years have been saying, hey, so I have lights in my house. It would be great if they wouldn't reflect into my eyes off my screen. I was trying to put my finger on it. I was like, yeah, this looks like so clean. This looks so good. Oh my God, Asus, if this thing isn't final yet, fix this shift key. That is a no, bad engineer. You think about what you've done. Jeez. Okay, hold on a second. I wanna check something first though. I wanna see if this one also runs at high refresh rate. I doubt it. There's no way. No, it's 60 hertz only. Okay. It feels like I'm going so fast because of the like ultra mega wide aspect ratio here. Asus, am I doing it right? This is a perfect example of why I've always been so against 4K displays on laptops. This is a 2080 class card. We're running Doom Eternal, which is a very well optimized game. And we can't even take advantage of the 120 hertz display because we're only getting anywhere from 60 to 70 FPS. And get this, we're not getting enough FPS because it's 8 freaking megapixels instead of 3.5. So definitely good progress. And what's nice about a 4K display is that you can set it to a lower resolution. And as long as you're not looking at text, it'll still look reasonably sharp, especially at this size. You're not gonna really notice that interpolation like you would way back in the day when we were talking about like, you know, 1280 by 1024 displays and trying to run them at anything other than native. In fact, we could try that really quick. 2560 by 1440, apply. You're really not giving up much. Obviously, you're not getting the full benefit of your 4K display, but if my argument is that there's really no noticeable benefit to it at the screen size anyway, then I guess it doesn't matter. It just means that you can't run at 144 hertz or, for that matter, 165, which one of these other models can do. That's right, 165 hertz here, ladies and gentlemen. So this is the Zephyrus S15. With a 1440p 165 hertz display. So smooth. So smooth. Excuse me. So smooth I lost control of my bowel there. Need some new underwear. Yeah, this thing's freaking, it's going, boys. Okay, these are early units. I would say that the black levels on this one compared to either the other two I've seen so far are not as impressive. I'm not that blown away with the image on this one, but the smoothness is something else. Is this TN? No, it doesn't seem to be. Definitely not as impressed with this panel, at least in its early form here. But that's okay, this wasn't the one that I was expecting to blow me away anyway. And I'm just excited that the G14 has a really, really nice looking display on it. All right, I think I've seen enough of this. Let's go 360 hertz. Oh, it's crazy. 360 hertz is like something else. Not to mention that even ripping this around, like, yeah, it's not sharp, but it is dangerously close to looking sharp, that text. 360 FPS, 1080. That's right, you're stuck with 1080 on this one, but there's only so much DisplayPort bandwidth, guys. Good black levels on this one for sure. It's so smooth. It's like, turn that motion blur off, get that frame rate way up. Yeah, 1080 is a little low for this size. Like, you know, in the foliage of the trees and stuff like that, you can see like kind of shimmery, kind of stair-steppy aliasing. But man, if what you're after is something that just looks fluid, oh wow. Just like the 4K 120 hertz model, like we're going to legitimately need next generation hardware, which is what we will get, of course, in order to take advantage of this laptop. I'm only running at 1080p high, which again, this is Doom Eternal, guys. The thing runs on a well-optimized toaster and I'm getting 220 to 250 frames per second. Let's drop it down. It doesn't look great at lower than high. Try medium. And it looks like it's running on an Xbox One S. Yeah, it's still capped. It seems like a CPU bottleneck. I actually don't know what the specs of this model are gonna be once we finally see the true production version of it, but I sure hope it has a Ryzen 5000 processor in it. I mean, we're getting all 250 of those frames per second displayed on screen, which is nice, super smooth. Just like my segue to ending this video. Thanks, Asus, for sending over these pre-production laptops for us to check out. It's really exciting for me to see feedback that I've given many times over the years implemented in a real product. I am stoked with the results, and I'm looking forward to checking out the real ones with next generation hardware inside. Oh yeah, subscribe.